Hey everyone, myself, your mentor, Neha Gupta, and I'm going to teach you the current affairs which are relevant for your upcoming RBI SEBI NABARD examinations. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you have not subscribed our channel till now, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification, because this is going to help you and stay connected with our channel. And this is the Telegram group which you can join from the link in the description below. This Telegram group provides you with free quizzes as well as you can ask your queries on this group. And this is the RBI Grade B 2022 course, guys, that we are offering, wherein you will get videos, PDFs, and mock tests. Along with all these facilities, you will also get your preparation for final interviews of RBI Grade B through mock interviews that we conduct on our channel. And this is the booklet that you will get if you enroll in our course. And right now, we are running a 30% discount, which you can avail by using the RBI 30 coupon code. And if you have any query related to the course or related to examination in general, then you can ask us on this number. So that was all about the basic introduction. Now let's begin with the first question, which is a very important report. Okay. How much reduction was seen in the CO2 emissions in the world in 2020 as per the BP statistical review of World Energy 2021? So first of all, let me tell you that this report is released by this organization named BP. PLC, which is a British multinational oil organization. So it is basically releasing this report, and this organization releases this report on an annual basis. Now guys, let me tell you that there was not a single question from this report in past 2 to 3 years in your RBI SEBI or NABARD examination, largely as I have seen. So I'm saying this from my experience, but does that mean that you can ignore this report? So in my perspective, not at all, because this is a very important report that is telling you the entire scenario, entire trends in the energy market for the entire year of 2020. Therefore, it is very important for you guys to have a keen knowledge about the energy market trends, which country was the largest consumer, or the CO2 emissions at large. So this report is going to tell you about all that in here only. So we have the five options: 6.3%, 5.4, 4.5, 3.2, 2.5, 3.4 or 2.5. So these are the five options, out of which 6.3 is the right answer. So guys, this is the largest ever CO2 emission that has been seen in the world. So this is the largest ever annual CO2 emission since the year 1945. And as per this report, we need, the globe needs to maintain this reduction rate in CO2 emissions if we want to achieve the goals of Paris Agreement. So this is a very drastic decline in CO2 emissions that was seen in the year 2020. And we all know why such a decline happened in CO2 emissions in 2020, because majority of the organizations, industries, manufacturing facilities were all closed down across the world. Therefore, this CO2 emission reduction was seen in 2020. Now let us understand what this report tells us in detail about different energy sectors. Okay, so here is the overview about primary global energy consumption. Now what does this mean? First of all, you should be aware about the meaning of primary global energy consumption. So basically, it is the consumption of the fossil fuels or the various energy resources which are used to produce electricity. So all the resources that are used to produce the electricity are under this primary global energy sources, are the primary global energy sources of the world. So oil, natural gas, renewables, nuclear energy, hydropower, thermal, solar, wind, all these are primary global energy sources from which we extract electricity, we generate electricity. Okay. Now let us understand what the overall scenario was in 2020 in terms of primary global energy consumption. So in 2020, it fell by 4.5%, which was the largest annual decline since 1945. So here you have been given the definition of primary energy. What are the sources and what is the meaning of primary energy, that I have already explained to you. Cumulatively, fossil fuels like coal, natural gas, oil, etc. still constitutes over 80% of the energy mix. So here you can see primary global energy consumption pattern of 2020, wherein you have the largest share occupied by the oil itself. Although oil witnessed the largest decline in 2020, but still it is occupying 31.2% share in the global energy mix. The next major source is natural gas, which has 27.2% of share. Then the third one is our coal, 24.7% occupied by coal itself. So all these three fossil fuels together combined becomes more than 80% of the total energy consumption in the world. Then we have the nuclear energy at 4.3%, hydro energy at 6.9%, and renewables at 5.7%. So all these energy sources have faced decline in 2020 except for the hydro energy. So hydropower energy as well as the renewables, solar energy and wind energy, have witnessed a growth in 2020. So now let us see how much decline these three sources have faced and how much gain does hydropower and renewables has seen in 2020. But before that, let us see something about the countries itself. Country-wise, over 95% of the countries that were surveyed in this report experienced a decline in energy consumption. Obviously, why would they consume more? Why would they consume energy more when their industries and manufacturing facilities are shut down already? So this is not only due to the industry shutdown, but also transportation activity was also slowed down in 2020. Therefore, oil was the energy source that faced the major decline in 2020. Okay. Country-wise, US, India, and Russia contributed the largest annual declines in energy consumption. And here, China is the exception. China's consumption grew by 2.1% over 2019. So whereas all the major economies are facing declines in primary global energy consumption, but on the other hand, China is showing a growth of 2.9% in comparison to its growth in the year 2019. And this is, however, is below than China's 3.8% of average growth over the previous 10 years. But that doesn't count here because when all these major countries were facing decline, China was the only country that was facing growth. Can you guys tell me what was the GDP forecast for China in 2020? Or I would say, what is the GDP growth rate of China in 2020? Okay, so this is your question for the day that you have to tell me in the comment section below. As far as CO2 emissions are concerned, we have already discussed everything in the question itself. Okay, now talking about oil. So oil accounts for 3/4 of the decline in the primary global energy consumption. So we all know that oil is one source that has faced the major decline in 2020 because of the crashing of global prices of oil, as well as the slowing down of production of oil. So that is the primary reason for which the 3/4 of the decline, the entire decline in the primary global energy consumption, that is 4.5%. So out of this 4.5% decline, 3/4 of the decline is due to the oil. However, despite this sharp decline in the oil consumption, we have already seen that it is still taking 31.2% share in the entire energy mix. So that makes oil an important component as well as a hard one to eliminate. The next point here is natural gas. So natural gas is the second most popular fossil fuel that is used in the world at present. Okay, so it has a global average growth rate of 2.9%. That was the annual rate. But in 2020, it declined by 2.3%. So it faced a decline in the growth rate of by 2.3%, which is the largest decline in natural gas demand on record. USA was the global leader in both natural gas production as well as consumption. Next comes the coal. Coal was on decline since 2014. So there was an increased urge to reduce the consumption of coal since the year 2014. But the decline coal saw in 2020 was the largest annual decline on record at 4.2%. China remains the world's largest producer and consumer of coal with a more than 50% global share in both the categories. Here also, China witnessed a growth of 0.3% in coal consumption. Not at all for you important for you to remember. You don't need to remember this percentage. Just remember that China was the country that was the growth receiver in coal consumption in 2020. coal demand in OECD countries fell to the lowest level in the history of this review. Basically, since the time this review has started, back in the year 1965, this is the highest decline in the coal demand in OECD countries. How many countries are member of this OECD organization? 37. Majorly, all the developed countries are, developed or high-income countries are members of OECD. US coal demand in 2020 also fell to the lowest level since the review began it in 1965. Okay, so that was all about coal. Now let's discuss about renewables because they saw a growth. Solar electricity consumption. Okay, first point here is global renewable energy consumption grew by 10% in 2020. A huge growth proportion that the renewable energy sector has seen. Solar electricity consumption rose by 20%, but wind power provided the largest contribution to the renewable growth. So wind power also increased, solar electricity also increased. Solar capacity increased by 127 gigawatts and wind capacity grew by 111 gigawatts. So this is the growth, guys. This is not the actual capacity. Okay, the actual capacity, the total wind and solar power capacity at present is 1,441 gigawatts in the world. China was the largest individual contributor to renewable energy growth. So I have already told you guys that China is a major player in the renewable energy market. Next here is the nuclear, which is also which has also seen the decline by 4.1%. US here remains the world's largest consumer of nuclear power with 31% share of the global total. So this country is alone accounting for the 31% of the nuclear power consumption, followed by South Africa, South Korea, China. So these are the countries that are following the footsteps of US. So guys, that was all about this World Energy Market Report. I hope that you have understood about this report. Now let's move on to the second question. How many people die in a minute worldwide due to famine as per the Hunger Virus Multipliers Report? So, first of all, this report is released by Oxfam International. Guys, can you tell me where is the headquarter of this organization, Oxfam International? Coming back to the question, so a total of 11 people died due to famine in the world as compared to the COVID-19 deaths. So this hunger has outpaced COVID-19 disease as well because 11 people are dying due to the famine only as compared to the death rate of 7 people per minute of COVID-19. Now let us discuss the facts about this report, which are not very much in detail because this report has highlighted the hunger virus. Okay. So I have told you this point only. 11 people are dying every minute as against 7 people per minute death toll of COVID-19. So it is overtaking COVID-19 disease as well. So hunger is the new emerging virus. Actually not new. It existed since the human race began. Total 155 million people are at the highest risk of famine or food crisis. War zones like Afghanistan, Ethiopia, South Sudan, Syria, Yemen are the worst hunger hotspots, and global warming and economic recessions have increased the global food prices by 40%. So this is the major reason. Global warming and economic recession induced by the COVID pandemic have increased the global food prices. Which organization maps the global food prices? Global Food Price Index is released by FAO. Food and Agricultural Organization. So it releases this index on a monthly basis. Okay, so remember this point as well. So that was all about this report. Now we have slightly lightweight questions. Where was the world's deepest swimming pool for underwater diving located? Where is, basically? So you have the five cities, out of which Dubai is the right answer. So it has also recorded its name in the Guinness World Record for being the deepest diving pool swimming. Now, it has also resurrected the sunken city inside the pool itself. So, it is basically giving you the experience of scuba diving inside the swimming pool itself. Okay, so that was all about this swimming pool. Now, let's move on to the next question. Recently, Argentina has won Copa America tournament. With which sport is Copa America tournament related? So, it is related to football. Argentina has won this Copa America. Guys, here you have Golden Boot Award. as you have the best cricketer award in the cricket match, the man of the match award or the hat-trick player. So such kinds of awards are there in cricket match as well. Similarly, in this football match, in the football matches in generally, you have golden boot award, golden ball award, and golden glove award, etc. So golden boot is given to top scorer. Golden ball award is given to the best player, as well as golden glove award is given to the goalkeeper, best goalkeeper who has performed the best. So out of all these awards, golden boot is the most important award because it is given to the man of the match, the top scorer. So in this match, Lionel Messi has got this award, as well as he has also got the award of golden ball. So he has got both these awards. Now guys, I would like to ask a question from you. Can you tell me which footballer has hand of gold? So this hand of God is the legendary goal made by which football player? Let me tell you that football player also belongs to Argentina. So he is of the same country. You have to just name that footballer who has scored this hand of God goal in the comment section below. Next question is, which country won the UEFA Euro 2020? So this is again a football tournament, and here Italy has won it. Now here the golden boot award went to Cristiano Ronaldo. Apart from him, there is another person that you should be aware of, and that is Marcus Rashford. Now he is basically from the England football player, and Italy has won this match against England, and because he missed the penalty goal, therefore there are racist attacks against him on social media platforms. Therefore, he is very much in the news. So remember, he is an English football player. Okay, Marcus Rashford. He is basically a black man. Therefore, these racist attacks are addressed towards him. Okay, who is the author of A New Cold War, Henry Kissinger and the Rise of China book? So, Sanjay Baru, Rahul Sharma, Preeti Saini, both AND, both BNC. Option D is the right answer. Here, the authors are Sanjay Baru and Rahul Sharma. So, they both have written this book. So, that was all about today's video. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching it.